Got it. Got it. Got my camo.
Master killer.
Ruthless killer. That's all I was waiting on. Bastards.
Okay, I finally earned the Master Killer Challenge. Look at my challenge card. The boy, look at him. Ooh. Now, what makes this worthy of a commentary, right? Well, in the age of skill-based matchmaking, in the age of reverse boosting, being legitimate is the only way to be. Being truthful on YouTube is the only way to be. And I pride myself on being able to do that. However, I've also always earned this challenge card with natural attrition. I didn't have to camp to get it, right? And in this gameplay, I want to show you how I achieved the last thing that I needed to achieve to earn the Master Killer card, and that was get a Ruthless Kill. And of course, getting a Ruthless Kill shouldn't be a big thing, right? It's only a 15 kill streak without dying. Yeah, try that in this game. In this game, it's more difficult if you are trying to do it legitimately. You know, I'm not in hardcore mode because I don't play hardcore very often. I'm in regular pubs. I have two of my friends in the lobby. We're playing domination. So you got Blizzo and you got Bootney Finesworth. We're in the lobby. Everybody's doing their thing. I'm not doing any call outs to them saying, hey, bro, where are they? Where are they? As you can see, I'm just trying to navigate to get to the spawn because I know once I get close to the spawn, these spawns in this game don't flip traditionally like they used to, even though you're right on the other team's objective, right? I'm right up on their flag. The spawn should have literally flipped, but they don't. And I know that. So I know the only way for me to get these 15 kills is to try to bum rush their spawn and catch them off guard as they are spawning into the game. It's the only way. There's too many variables that you can get shot on. And that's why even the class setup that I have, the War Machine, I know exactly that the War Machine, when you earn it and you use it, it counts towards your score streak. It counts towards your kills. So why not use it? I got armor. And I got that armor like just that, in case I get hit from the side or I'm challenging somebody and that person I'm challenging, like they just take me out. But listen to this. Watch me talk crap to my homies.
Oh, nice. Ooh. Damn. Nice. Ooh.
All up in your Look, head. I was talking line crap up. Because I know that how close I am up. To earning this emblem that I've been trying to get. But what I normally do is I normally just play and I don't camp. But in this game, I had to camp and I had to take a different strategy in order to get it. Now, here's where things get a little tricky. Check it out. 14. There it is. 14 score streak. Now, you know, it's time to camp. Get my camp on, camp life on. And here I am in the back of the map doing my thing, trying to get that one elusive kill.
Got it.
And as soon as I get it, bam, what happens? I get killed. This is the reason why you have to do it. This game is too dang hard, man. Why did they make this game so hard? Why did they make this game not be fun? I'm trying to have fun. Fun to me is, again, playing regular. And now that I've earned it, I know I just earned the emblem. Now I can just play the game how I want to play it, right? But I'm in that mode. It's like a baller. You know, when you just know you're feeling it. So now I'm feeling it. I'm still going to do the cheesy stuff that I need to do. I'm going to be elusive. And that's what you got to do in this game. Be elusive. And that's just crazy. Look at these people jumping around. And as you notice, there's level 100s on my team, which is me one. And I don't know who the other ones are. And there's level 100s on the other team. So I'm literally battling people who are literally trying to take me out or who already have this card, which kind of shows that they may have some proficiency at the game. And now gaming, now that you have all these people reverse boosting and all these people lying about how they earn their streaks and how they earn their nuclears and all that, is it going back to the regular gameplays? People going to be looking at everybody's gameplays to see how legitimate you are, who your competition was, questioning you. Now, I know most of you guys aren't questioning me because you're like, oh, you're just Wayne. You're not your channel is basically dead. I'm posting this for the maybe 30 people that's going to view my video, and 30 people, enough 30 of them, maybe 4 or 5 of them might leave comments, and then I might get 10 likes. Right. So what's the use of posting this channel video commentary? I'm posting it because I'm legit. I want everybody to know that I'm legit. And again, in life, there's no shortcuts. So I can't do it in the game. It may be that's why I'm not as successful as many other commentators and YouTubers out there. I'm just me, Wayne, the average gamer, doing things the legit way because this is what I do. This has been your boy, Wayne, the average gamer. Thanks for viewing my channel. Hope to see you again. And I'm out, this mother sucker. Deuces! Deuces! Deuces!
Well, who are you walking in the door?
We got it.
GG's. Whoa.
GG's, bro. GG's.